Thank you for joining us this morning for our Sunday reflection. This past Sunday here at First Assembly, I have been preaching a sermon series on spiritual warfare. This past Sunday's title was Spiritual Warfare, Overcoming Strongholds. So let me take just a moment and review what we have said the last few Sundays in this spiritual warfare series. First of all, spiritual warfare is the war between good and evil. Spiritual warfare is when any born-again Christian confronts evil, which is a constant thing for a Christian. We are constantly in spiritual warfare for our soul to stay committed to God. Thanks be to the Lord that He helps us and that He strengthens us. A stronghold is any area of influence or authority of evil that might be in our lives. If you'd like to take your Bible and turn with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 10, I want to read verses 3 through 5. The Bible says, though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of Christ, and we take captive every thought to it to obedient to Christ. So the Bible tells us here that spiritual weapons of God has authority to bring down strongholds in your life. Again, a stronghold is any area of influence of evil or of sin in your life. Now, I want to give you five things that I think will help you in pulling down strongholds. First of all, as you look at your life, as you pray and as you seek the Lord, define areas in your life. Just say, you know, I think these are areas in my life where sin could have a stronghold, where maybe the enemy, where the devil could have a place of authority in my life. You know, sometimes we just have to be honest with ourselves and take an honest inventory of who we are. As you pray, you will see areas of your life that the Lord can strengthen. That's good that you see them. When you do see them, number two, don't rationalize them, but confess them to God. You know, sometimes we think that if we just don't talk to God about something, maybe He won't notice. But you know, we know that's true. God knows everything about us, and He loves us. God loves you. Confess it to God. Tell God, I'm having trouble in this area. It's a difficulty for me. It's an area of stronghold that I seem to have trouble overcome. Confess it to God, and He will help you. On this specific area of a stronghold, fast and pray. Begin to reach out to God and say, Lord, I'm praying specifically about this area. I'm praying, Lord, that You will help me in this area. The Bible says some things come only by prayer and fasting. So I encourage you to pray and fast specifically about certain areas of your life. A fourth thing to do is go to the Word of God and any scriptures that you can find that pertain to this particular area of your life, memorize them, quote them, speak them. When you feel like you're in an area of temptation or an area of trial, then begin to quote these scriptures and just place the Word of God into this equation. God's Word has power. And then last of all, have faith and believe. Have a zero tolerance. God, with Your help, You're going to help me overcome. I can bring down this stronghold in my life through the power of God. Again, the five things are define the area. Number two, confess it. Don't rationalize. Number three, fast and pray specifically in that area. Number four, look up any scriptures that pertain to that area and quote them on a regular basis. Believe them. And then fifthly, last of all, have faith. And I particularly want you to know that I'm available if I could help you. If you live here in the Bristol area, particularly members of our congregation that I'm speaking to today, I'd be glad to fast and pray with you and help you as we just spiritual warfare together, as we join together. May God bless you, and I'll see you next time on a Sunday Reflection. Thank you.